Good morning, Palm Springs students and staff. Today is Tuesday, April 23rd, and welcome back to PSTV. I'm Adija.
And I'm Sarah.
And this is Angel. Breaking news this morning. The details have been set for Fast Field Day.
If you earn a 3, 4, or 5 on the ELA or math test in May.
If you increase a level from the last FAST, known as PM2.
If you make learning gains from the last FAST test.
You can attend a field day. It's on Wednesday, May 29th in 4th period for 6th grade, 5th period for 7th grade, and 6th period for 8th grade.
And you gave feedback, and Admin listened. We will have a bouncy castle, Cane's Cones, a DJ, and snacks.
This is an event you don't want to miss, so mark your calendars.
To ensure you can go, make sure to attend our next Saturday school.
We have only one more Saturday left for extra help in ELA, Civics, and 8th grade science.
Saturday, May 4th is for math only.
Be here at 8:30 a.m. You can wear whatever you want, no uniform necessary.
The day ends at 1:30 p.m.
You'll get a free lunch and snacks as well.
Get all the help you can because 7th and 8th graders kick off our FAST testing next week with the ELA on Wednesday, May 1st.
6th graders will take their ELA FAST on Thursday, May 2nd.
7th graders take civics on Tuesday, May 7th. 8th graders will be in testing groups the day also.
6th graders, your math is on Wednesday, May 8th.
7th and 8th graders, your math is Thursday, May 9th, and that includes algebra and geometry.
Then finally, on Thursday, May 16th, 8th graders will take their science EOC, while 7th graders take their science diagnostic.
You want to do your best, because you do not want to miss the field day.
8th graders, going to grad venture. You will have a meeting on Friday during first period.
That's when you will receive your t-shirt and sign up for your bus.
Remember, there are 4 buses total. So even if you don't end up on a bus with your friends, you can still hang out with them when you get to the parks.
You'll get more information about the trip this Friday during first period and throughout the week here on PSTV.
Teachers and staff members, you can now vote on prom king and queen. So, Sarah, what will you be wearing to prom?
I still need to look for a dress. What about you?
We don't speak on that. But anyways, prom tickets go on sale on Monday.
Tickets are $60, which includes admission and unlimited soft drinks, appetizers, chips, dip, cookies, and brownies.
You can buy tickets before school only in the 8th grade office.
Prom is Friday, May 10th at the Airport Hilton from 7 until 9:45 at night.
Our chorus students had an amazing experience over the weekend.
They got to see the Broadway musical Hamilton and perform in the lobby beforehand. Wow, what a great trip.
Our boys volleyball team won their first game against Lantana. And I wasn't there, but I heard my boy Alex cooked. So, good job, Alex. The boys play again today at Congress and again tomorrow back here at home.
You can attend for just $2.
If you see a member of the team, congratulate them. PSTV's Guillermo G and Anthony R and Brandon R.
Stephen S., John Carlos R., Isaias M.,
Christian M., Dylan L., Christian N.,
Anthony V., Edwin L., Alexander S.,
Darnett R., Morgan D., and Jonathan P.
Our track team also has a meet today at Lake Worth Middle.
Palm Springs placed in many different events last time. Let's hope this time our students do just as great. Good luck. So make sure to congratulate everybody on the track team. Hopefully they do well. I will be in attendance to watch them.
6th, 7th, and 8th graders who made honor roll for quarter three will celebrate later this week.
6th graders will get recognition on Thursday in 6th hour.
7th graders on Friday in period 5.
And 8th graders Friday in period 6.
All ceremonies take place in the cafeteria. You'll get passes later in the week.
The school year may be almost over, but we have a new face on campus.
When you go to the clinic, you'll now see a new nurse.
PSTV's Malia B talked to her about how she feels about being at PSMS so far.
My name is Janelle Correa. This is actually my very first school. I started working in the hospital setting, and then COVID, I was on the COVID unit, so it was a lot. And then I got pregnant, went home, had baby, been home with baby, and now I'm here. It's very busy. It's a big school, big middle school. It's a nice school though, and the kids seem pretty great so far. About me, I still play video games. I love Resident Evil, Avatar, stuff like that. I'm pretty easygoing, you know, so yeah. Green is my favorite color. Anything pasta, I love pasta.
Welcome to campus, Nurse Janelli.
If you have extra jeans at home, you can earn house points by donating them to one of our classes to celebrate Earth Week.
Global Perspectives sponsoring a Jeans for Teens project.
It takes 1,800 gallons of water to make one pair of jeans.
And 2.16 million tons of jeans are thrown away each year.
You could help teens and the Earth by donating your old jeans.
Drop off your old and clean jeans to your house box in Mrs. Masang's room 3207.
Let me repeat that, 3207. Anyways, for each pair of jeans you donate, your house will get points.
From the Earth to the Moon, we've been giving you updates on moon phases all year here on PSTV.
When you look up at the sky tonight, you'll see a full moon.
The full moon is when the sun and the moon are aligned on opposite sides of the Earth, and 100% of the moon's face is illuminated by the sun.
Speaking of the sun, will we see a lot of it today?
Let's check in with Shara in the PSTV Weather Center.
Thanks, anchors. We will be seeing a little bit of the sun as the clouds are going to be covering it, but it's going to be partly cloudy with a high of 78 and a low of 66. There is no chance of rain. Thank you. Back to the anchors.
Tabassum, Sharp. Both beginning before. These are all important words that start with B that you'll see on your FAFSA.
PSTV's Adrian H. shows us four words that start with the letter B in English and Spanish that you need to know.
Remember those words for your test starting next week.
Now let's wrap up with today's SLO.
This week is about understanding your role as a community member.
What characteristics make up a welcoming and safe community and why?
Think about your answer and be ready to share after today's newscast.
And before we go, one last call to fill out your teacher appreciation form.
You'll see it in your email from Ms. McElonin.
Please submit as part of the very special broadcast PSTV produces every year for Teacher Appreciation Week.
So, Sarah, what teacher do you appreciate?
I appreciate all of them, actually. What about you?
You know, I appreciate all my teachers. You know, they teach me a lot. Because, you know, they're very teacherful. Anyways, students, that's all for today.
Stay tuned for today's birthdays.
Bye.